Okay, welcome back everyone. Mark here from Breakthrough Assault as the German general for turn two of the Gazala Firestorm, and I'm joined from No Dice, No Glory by my allied British counterpart, Iron Tom.
Hey Mark, how you doing?
Yeah, good. So, what we've been doing tonight, you were seeing on there's another video we put up earlier, which was the results of turn two. And what this video is really showing, sorry, the results of turn one. And what we've been doing is actually we've pre-positioned what was going on in turn two. Rather than do a video of what was going through, we've actually done it behind the scenes. And just to be upfront on why we've done that, it occurred to us as we were playing, when you actually go through this normally, you can actually, if I zoom in here, you can see order. Phase two, battle phase, select an opponent, roll for the initiative of the battle, place a battle arrow, choose Firestorm troops, etc. etc. And what it means is, when you're just playing this, say you're just playing it with a few friends or at a club, you can string battles together. So, for example, let's say in turn one, let's say I had the initiative for three battles, I could actually go from C2 into C4. If I want it in the same turn, I could then go C4 into, which area is it here? Bravo 5. And if I won that one, I could go and do a third attack if I still had the initiative into Alpha 5. Which, because it kind of dawned on us as we were looking at it going, well, how are the Germans ever going to take Tobruk if they're only moving one square each turn? So, what we decided to do, we had to find a way to do it simultaneously online. So what we decided to do, there's a way you can play this using what's called kind of like the general's battle. So using the strength of the troops here, you can actually work out the outcome of a battle by rolling dice behind the scenes. So the first thing we did was, as normal, was roll for the number of battles, and we actually rolled up six. So what we did was we said if there's going to be more than one battle on an advance, or we've got the desire to push further, then what we would do is actually roll one of the battles behind the scenes. And if that battle was successful, we would count that result and then allow another, if you've got initiative again, allow another battle to happen. Now, it didn't really make a lot of difference in where we were going, except in one place, which is Bravo 6 into, let's check the number here, into, sorry, Charlie 6 into Charlie 7. So this first battle going into here, I committed Rommel and some Stukas, and it was defended by some Hurricanes, and I actually won that battle. We took the combined strength, which was four, versus the combined strength, which was two, for the allies, and it meant we both rolled a dice. I plus two to the result, and if I won, then I took the area, and I did because I actually rolled a six, so I got a total of eight versus. I can't remember what you rolled, Tom. Obviously, it wasn't enough. So,
Yeah, I rolled well, I don't think I rolled because you
oh,
got
there
a
was no way
six to
to
the
win it,
bonus,
yeah.
so there was no way I could beat it.
So actually, I destroyed his Firestorm troop, which goes back into Allied reinforcements, and took that area. Now, as you that then allowed me to do another attack, and obviously, I want to start cutting them the British off, so allow me to do another attack into Bravo 7. And because that's the last attack on that axis, we've stopped there because we want you guys to play those battles out. So it's allowing us to, what we try to do is balance, allow the sweeping battles the Germans had to progress, and then the important outcomes for each avenue of attack, we're going to hand it over to you, the players, to work out. So when we got these six battles, I've been incredibly lucky. I still had plus one to my roll because Rommel's still fighting. And I actually won initiative for every single battle. So while the British were very quick to reinforce and did that amazing role to be able to reposition their Firestorm troops where they needed them, the Germans have really are really living up to their Blitzkrieg name here and are going on the all-out offensive on the right flank. So we've got five battles for you. So the first one we've got is into Bravo 6. El Adeim and the airfield, and we've committed here the Panzers and the M14 47s against the Grants and the 25 pounders in there as well. So really key battle here, because we're fighting for 30 victory points. If I can take that, that is a really big deal. A cheeky little attack down in the bottom right here. I want key reason I want that 10 victory points, but also an airfield. If I can take that and that airfield, it basically means that Tom can only keep one set of Hurricanes for turn three, because he's only got one airfield to base them in. So it would mean I capture a set of aircraft, which gives me victory points, and I'd get 10 victory points down there. Perhaps one of the most important battles, though, is going to be into Bellamed. So Rommel himself is going to lead that, along with some Stukas. And that's 50 victory points. That is an Allied supply depot. If we take that, then it means that the Germans, the Allies, when they reinforce, can only reinforce into Tobruk. So it really secures my right flank. Knightsbridge, I needed to get an attack off into here. It's going to be really tough, but I needed to commit forces into it, really, to tie down Knightsbridge and stop them attacking into my flank as I do what is the more important advance in the weaker center. This is a fortified area. It's going to be really, really tough. Panzers and Stukas against Hurricanes and Grants, so fairly balanced, but of course, whatever battle we're fighting, I'm going to be coming up against minefields and barbed wire as well. So give your all to it. It'd be fantastic to win it. But whatever happens, I'm not going to be able to take that area, because even if it was a superb victory, he's still going to have the 201st Brigade there. So he'll still have a Firestorm unit on a fortified area. So I can't take that. The best we can do is whittle down those Firestorm troops ready to try and take it next turn. But that attack just tied those troops down and secured my, hopefully just tied up my left flank of my main right hook. Because we didn't manage to take 0.171 last turn, I need to retake it. I want to get that, because if I can get that, it just secures my rear. I don't like the idea of the 3rd Brigade coming into C2, winning, and then cutting me off, particularly as I move my 4 Firestorm troops up. It leaves me vulnerable. So I need to get that so I can then spread my Firestorm troops out and just secure my supply routes. Now, I did consider going into Bar Hashim, because if I can take that, it's really important, because you can see all these roads actually lead into here. But I kind of looked at it, and I kind of crunched it in my head a little bit. We would have to win enough and destroy that Firestorm troop. Now, even with a 7-2 victory, which is pretty good, there's only a 1 in 3 chance of destroying that Firestorm troop. And even if it was a superb win at A1, there's only a 50% chance of destroying it. It's just so unlikely. So it's really going to take 2 turns to destroy that. And it's only a 3-turn campaign. And even if I take it on turn 3, it hasn't really gained me anything by that stage, because there's no victory points for it. So I'd rather take that, and if we win, I capture that unit, and that gives me victory points. So it just works out a little bit better for me. Nothing really happening on the left flank here. The Italians are staying firm. I don't want to go on the offensive with infantry. They're nicely supplied. They've been resupplied across the minefield there. So they can sit out and dig in, should I say, really, around there. There's not a huge gain to be had. I can't cut across into Alpha 5 because I don't have Knightsbridge, and I don't want to go committing Italian infantry, which don't have an anti-tank capability, obviously, into Alpha 4. And there's not a huge deal. Well, yeah, I could get 20 points if I take that fortified area in there, but there's bigger battles to fight at the moment. So maybe something to look at in turn 3. So it's all gone a little bit quiet on the other flanks here. So that's it. As we'll do again, I'll write up what all the different Firestorm units are. I'll highlight if there's any special rules for particular areas. I'll obviously make a point so everyone understands what Rommel does, because he has some really cool rules, I'm really am gambling here. I'm in essence, I'm being the same as Rummel was. I'm being a bit of a chancer and going on the offensive. If I lose him, I lose my plus one initiative bonus to get the battle markers in my favor next turn. So, and also, Tom gets victory points for destroying him as well. So, if you're fighting over here, it's a big deal, guys. I need to do well. Don't let me down with Rummel. Tom, anything you want to say from the British point of view?
No, well, not having an initiative kind of hampered us to be able to enact any plans. All we could do was commit Firestorm troops. So, but yeah, trying to get it so that the Germans could, or the Axis could have a bit more chance to get up in Tobruk was necessary for us to do, to kind of talk through and resolve the intermediate battles before we, so we could determine if we could springboard onto the next area.
Yeah, so yeah, and if you did have the initiative, what battle would you have fought?
I was particularly looking to come down from A4 into B3 to counterattack to close that gap in the line where the Italians came through.
Yeah, absolutely. And obviously a big deal, a key one to retake with those 20 victory points as well. But something turn three could certainly easily bring, because we'll have to see, depending how I perform here, will depend whether you need to bring reinforcements up. But, you know, even if I destroy these troops here, they're going to come back into Tobruk. So you're always, basically, however well this goes, in turn three, there's going to be two Firestorm units in each one of those Tobruk's areas for me to face. There's not really another way that's going to play out. Because even if I wipe out all three of these Firestorm units, they're going to regenerate into here. So we'll just have to see. The most important thing for me is making sure my Firestorm units survive and I get an early initiative into Tobruk next turn, because if though my Firestorm units die, I've got no way. The furthest I can get is Charlie 1 into Charlie 2 into so really what I've committed here is what I have to take Tobruk with. No reinforcements are coming to that, so important times. You have to be the guy who designed it, Yokel, told me you've got to be aggressive and you've got to be lucky. It's the Axis as well. So guys, thanks for watching. So it's Sunday in the UK at the minute, Sunday evening, so I'll be getting the videos up now, and then I'll be writing the report Monday evening UK time, so that should be up Monday night, if not Tuesday morning. So you should be then, you'll have just under 2 weeks in order to play your games. And what we'll do is we'll call it on Sunday. Just getting my calendar up. So we'll be looking at the cutoff being as long as you get them in by about six o'clock, let's call it 6 o'clock, so we can get as many as possible, 6 o'clock British summer time, on the 19th of July. That will be the cutoff for it, but I'll put that in the article as well. So good luck, have fun, and as always, thanks for joining in. And Tom, we shall see how it goes. Thanks a lot.
All right, thank you much.